So I'll try my best to use Mandarin, but if I sometimes go into English, you'll translate. Oh, right. Then we need another speaker. As we are getting ready, if you look in your handout, in the very last page, we are looking at 2 Corinthians 5, 14 to 21.
我们刚刚最后结束的时候，我们在看这最handout的最后一页，最后一页我们看到 哥林多后书第5章第14到21节啊，在那里，这是最后的一个 slide， 可以帮我搬到那里。
If you turn to the back of your handout, there is 1 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 14 to 21. Yeah.
We mentioned this, it escaped to the very, very back of the whole slide. It escaped to go to the very, very back of the whole deck. The key passage here is verse 17. If you anyone is in Christ, he is a new creation. The old is gone, the new has come.
这段经文的主题是在第十七节，在那里说，在基督里我们都是新造的人，旧事已过，都成为新的。Yeah,
and the new creation has a new job.
这个新造的人有新的工作。In
verse 20, it says we are Christ's ambassadors.
第二十节告诉我们说，我们是基督的使者。Ambassador
is someone who lives in a foreign country but represents the home country.
这个使者这个人是住在外国，但是代表本国。And
we said that this ambassador has a special job, and it's called the Ministry of Reconciliation.
我们说这个使者有一个特别的工作，也就是使人与神和好的工作。Yeah,
so this new creation has a new job. Hey, Dongyang, keep going. Okay, good. Okay. 这个new creation has something that's very important, that's symbolized by three no's.
所以这个新造的人有三个特征，而这个三个特征都是从不开始。The
first one is this creature no longer lives for themselves, but for him who died for them.
第一个不就第十五节说他不再为自己而活，而是为那个为他死的主而活。不再为自己而活，所以我们工作的目的，the
purpose of our job, the purpose is no longer just for ourselves or for success, but for God, right?
所以我们工作的目的不再是为自己，不再是为成功，而是为主而活。而且呢，the
second point is 他不再，we no longer regard anyone from a worldly point of view.
第二点就是第十六节的是不再以世俗的眼光来看别人。That
means when we look at the people around us, we are using different eyes from the worldly eyes.
也就是当我们看我们周围的人，我们是以一个新的眼光，而不是以一个世界的眼光。Yeah.
So, and then the third one is we no longer count men's sins against them.
第三点是第十九节，不再以别人的罪来这个样子来看他们。
So, in other words, this new creature, 就是跟今天早上我们听到的信息很相似， right?
Yeah, this new creature is very similar to what we heard from this morning's message.
In this morning's message, it says, we are in the love of God. And if we are in the love of God, we have something to give to someone else.
今天早上告诉我们说，如果我们在神的爱中，我们就可以给出世界一些东西。
And so, the workplace spirituality is living in the love of God at your workplace.
所以就是说，你在工作的地方怎么样把你的信仰活出来呢？就是因为你活在神的爱中，你可以把爱在你的工作场合流露出来。And
three things about relationships, right? No longer live for themselves. No longer seeing other people through the same old eyes, and no longer counting their sins against them.
所以在工作场合，你的新的人际关系就是三个步，你要记得。第一个就是不再为自己而活；第二个就是不再以世俗的眼光来看他们；第三个就不再计算他们的错。
Yeah, so these are going to be the foundations, the framework for a lot.
下要谈的很重要的框架。
Okay, now I need you, Don Yang, to just hit escape and go back to the very beginning of the, all the way back to where we were. All the way back to where we were. Can you go back? All the, oh yes, excellent. Now you can go forward. Thank you.
Okay,
if this is our timeline, right, we are here.
This is, 这是我们的时间的，这个是时间的话。
不是这个，是今天的。
哦，今天的时间。
We are in a low point after lunch. We are digesting food. It's hard to concentrate.
现在是我们一天的最低点啊！刚刚吃过饭，所以我很难注意。
So, I'll try to keep you focused. But if you're not focused, I do what I do with my MBAs. I just ask you a question.
所以如果你有点困的话，我就会有时候会点着要你回答一些问题。
Okay, let's try. Our responsibility. Okay, now.As lay ministers, how do we witness?
所以我们这些是所谓的平信徒，我们怎么样来做见证呢？
We through our words.
第一个是借着我们的话语。
Through our works.
借着我们的工作。
And through helping others by prayer and financial support.
还有就是借着我们帮助别人，借着金钱的奉献啊，或者是祷告。
所以有口传，有身传，有柱传。Right? This is all different ways we share the gospel.
我们可以用这三种方法来分享福音。
So, I'm going to emphasize, but back in workplace, right? The most important thing we do at work is probably 身传 how we live, not just what we say, but how we live.
所以在工作场所最重要的不仅是我们说什么，最重要的一点就是我们怎么样活生活。
Okay, so I'm going to talk about workplace.Two dimensions of workplace spirituality. One is how you perform your job. The other is how you share your life.
也就是在工作场所的属灵生命呢，有两个方向，两个方面。第一个是你的工作成绩，第二个是怎么样分享你的生命。
So I think of it as two different, almost orthogonal parts of your workplace.
我觉得这好像是你工作场的两支垂直线。
But you obviously have to do well.Serve well. To serve well moves you in this direction, and then to share generously moves you in the other direction. You want to maximize the space under the curve.
所以有两个方向，一个方向就是说你服侍的好，就工作的好。第二个方向呢，就是你跟别人分享的好。所以我们最希望呢，就是两个都做到极好。
Right. Some people are very good at serving.But they're not very generous with sharing their life. People around them don't know who they are, don't even know they're a Christian.
有一些人他工作的成绩非常的好，但他却很不愿意分享自己的生命，周围的人甚至都不知道他是基督徒。
Some people they're sharing their faith all the time, but nobody wants to hear them because they say, "Why don't you just do your job better?"
有一些人天天晚上传福音，但周围的人不想听他，为什么呢？因为大家就说你工作的果效很需要。
对不对？所以，工作我想早上 talk first about performing your job one dimension, I'll talk about sharing your life, which is the second one.
所以第一点我们要谈工作的果效。
Okay, so the one passage is very useful when you think about your work is how Jesus answered the question about that he was asked in Matthew 22.
有一方面帮助你啊，要思考一下的，就是主耶稣在马太福音22章所说的一句话。
Remember, people asked him, "Shall we pay Roman taxes?"
记得有人问他说，我们应该向罗马缴税吗
？That's a tricky question, right?
这是一个非常诡诈的问题。
It's a difficult question because the Jews are under the Roman rule, but they feel that they have a direct accountability to God.
犹太人虽然是受罗马政府的管辖，但犹太人觉得他们最上层的管辖权应该在神那里。
So I'm a child of God. You're not a child of God. What do I want to pay taxes to you for?
如果我是神的孩子，你不是神的孩子，我为什么要跟你缴税
？So what? Remember what Jesus said. Jesus said, "Give me a coin. Whose picture is on the coin?"
记不记得耶稣说，你给我一个硬币，看看上面是谁的头号
？They say it's Caesar's.
他说是凯撒的头号。
He said, "Well, then, give unto Caesar what is Caesar's, and give unto God what is God's."
所以耶稣回答说，凡属于凯撒的就给凯撒，凡属于神的就给神。
So, how did he answer that question about Roman taxes? Did Did he say paid or not paid?
到底他回答是要付税呢，还是不要付税？
He's saying paying Roman taxes is not inconsistent or incompatible with rendering yourself unto God.
所以他的意思就是说，你向罗马政府付税，并不代表你没有把自己交托给神。
So I want to draw an inference from that. You know, that first point is know your role.
所以我觉得，因为这个原则是想给大家一些指点。第一点就是你要知道你自己的角色。
In a pluralistic society with people with many faiths.
我们这是一个多元文化，很多人有各种不同的信仰。
They start with very different starting points from you.
别人的起点跟你的起点不一样。
Sometimes you're in a position of authority. It's your job to make a decision about something.
有时候你是在一种权威，你是有这个做决定的这个权威。
Sometimes in a position of influence. If you're not in a position of authority, your job is to influence.
而有时候呢，你的角色只是一个影响的角色，你没有这个权利做决定。
You need to know which role you are in.
所以你需要很清楚的知道你自己角色是什么。
If you are under authority, you do not say, "Well, I'm a Christian. You're not a Christian. You don't know. I don't listen to you."
所以如果你在某一个权柄之下，你不能说我是基督徒，你不是基督徒。
If you disagree, you may influence that decision.
如果你对某一个决定不同意的话，你只能影响这个决定。
When it's your job to make that decision, you make that decision. When it is not your job, your responsibility is to influence.
所以如果你有这个权柄做决定的时候，你就做决定。但如果你没有这个权柄的话，你要记得，你只是一个影响的角色。
You may not like Roman taxes. That does not mean that it's your job to not pay Roman taxes.
虽然你不愿意向罗马政府付税，但你并没有这个权柄不去付税。
Okay, so that's my first point. Just understand your authority and influence spheres in your job. And the second thing is you honor your duties. Do a good job.
第二个就是你把工作做好。
I remember I was at a university, I won't mention the name. There were two people working for the business school fixing computers.
我记得我在一个地方工作，有两个不同的人来帮我们商学院修理电脑。One
is a Christian and one is a non-Christian.
有一个是基督徒，有一个不是基督徒。
The thing is, though, when my computer is broken and I take it to the non-Christian, he always fixes it very fast.
但是如果我的电脑坏了，我每一次拿给那个不是基督徒的，他100%会帮我修好。
But when I take it to the Christian, sometimes it's fixed, sometimes it's not fixed.
但是如果我把坏的电脑拿给基督徒， 那个基督徒去修，有时候修得好，有时候不能。So
who should I take the computer to?
所以如果我电脑坏的话，你觉得我应该拿给谁修呢？
Some people say, "Look, I'm a Christian. I only deal with Christian businesses."
有一些人说我是基督徒，我只跟基督徒打商业交道。
I understand that from a visceral point of view.
我可以知道你的思路。
But a computer is a computer.
但是你的计算机就只是一个计算机。
On the one hand, if you're a Christian, you do your job, you do your best you can, right? If it's not your job and you cannot do it well, maybe there's another job where you can do well.
所以你是基督徒的话，你就应该把你自己岗位上的工作做好。如果你觉得这个岗位上你不可能做好，可能你就需要换工作。
So you honor your duties as a Christian.
所以，身为一个基督徒，你要工作好好的做好。
And if you're in an authoritative position, a position of authority, then it's very important that you be fair.
尤其是如果你是有一个权柄的时候，你要特别的小心。
Enforce fairness.
一定要公平。
When I was a professor, I am still a professor. One day I got an email from a student. It says, "Professor Lee, I'm going to have a Bible study tonight, and I will be. May I have an extra day for my assignment for my homework?" You know, what's important is he wants me to know that he's a Christian and I'm a Christian. He wants me to know we have something in common, which is good.
Right? Which is good.
Why is that
important?
Because, you know, God does not bribe, God does not put words, God does not say, if you become a Christian, then all your problems are gone. He doesn't bribe us. All these people, you know, I have a group who is in China, because they own a company, they have Christians and non-Christians, right, in the same company.
我知道有一些人，他们是一些基督徒的商人，然后在那里有一些做着自己的工厂，然后在工厂里面呢，有一些员工是基督徒，有一些不是。
So they have Bible studies. They encourage people. They even allow them time out so they can go to these studies.
所以他们在那里有查经，当然这个非常鼓励员工，甚至给他们就是说工作休息时间，让他们能够就是不去工作而去查经。
That's really good, right? But then you find that they have different Bible studies for the believers and the non-believers. It's pretty common. Well, pretty soon you notice that once you become a Christian, you go from here to here. But where are all the managers? They're over here. So now we have dynamics at work that we don't want to have.
如果是这样的情况，那你在工作中间关系的互动就非常不平衡。
Yeah, so if you're in a position, you have to be fair. In fact, you might be too tough on the Christians, but you have to be at least fair, right? Because, you know, I'll tell you another example, right? USC has one of the most vibrant Christian groups among the student bodies, many, many Christian groups.
对，另外一个例子就是南加州大学，在那里有很多很多的基督徒。
I went to speak there and I discovered, but you know, the day I went, they were honoring a past president who had been president for many years there. He's a Christian.
有一次我去那边讲学的时候，刚好那一天他们上一任的校长死了，而那个校长是一个非常认真的基督徒。So
I was standing there, and one after another, people came up to talk about this man.
所以我在那里给他的这一个就是纪念会的时候，一个接着一个人上去来陈述他的过去。All
these people talked about his faith, but the people who were talking were Muslims, Hindus, Jews, and many others.
所有的人上去都是在回想他的信仰，但上去所讲的人都是有不同的背景，有的是印度教，有的是回教的。He
after became president, he revived the Department for Religious Studies, which was not there at the time.
他成为校长以后，在那里建立了一个宗教研究院。First
person he appointed for that department is a Jewish woman.
他所指定的第一个研究院院长是一个犹太妇女。对。And
the second one was a Muslim lawyer.
第二个指定的人是一个回教的律师。He
felt that the campus needs to think about God. And he is confident that when they start thinking about God, many will become Christians. What I'm saying is, you know, if you're a Christian and you're in a pluralistic society, you have to be fair. That's the main point.
所以重点就是在于，如果你是一个基督徒，在这个多元的文化之中，你必须要做一个公平人。
Second model principle. So,
还有一个就是第二个领悟的原则。
You know, Jesus says if they want you to go 1 mile with them, go the second mile.
我们都听说过耶稣说，如果有人要你走1里的话，你就走2里。
And the second mile, they say, they joke that the traffic is very light on the second mile. Nobody wants to go the second mile. You won't get crowded.
Yeah, 我就跟你讲说，愿意走第二里的那一个路会很拥挤，因为大部分人不愿意走。
But when you go to second mile, most people recognize it. They don't, may not believe your, what's in the Bible, but they recognize you're going second mile.
但是如果你走第二里的时候，虽然别人见不到你所相信的神，但是别人会注意到你所做的事。
So let me just say one more thing. You know, Christians today often get sidetracked by many tangential issues.
还有另外一个很重要的就是，我发现今天的基督徒常常被一些边缘的一些事情所失去了注意力。
We are louder about our views on social and political things than we are about God who died for human beings.
有时候我们对政治上的一些事情、社会上的一些事情，我们大声地跟别人争论，而常常忘记了去讲我们信仰的中心，也就是我们神为我们死。
So you are not surprised that the society only knows Christians by what we are against and not what we are for.
所以如果现今的世界告诉我们说我们知道基督徒反对反对反对，但是基督徒到底是战争战争什么的，我们并不知道。
Yeah, C.S. Lewis wrote a book called Mere Christianity.
C.S. Lewis 写的这一本书叫《返璞归真》。
Okay. You know, he says only Christian. What does he mean? He means I'm talking only about the thing that every single Christian could not possibly mistake.
他说他的意思就是说我讲的是基督教的那个最纯、最真、最忠心的那些思想，每一个基督徒应该都知道。
The enormous common ground that we have.
也就是我们每一个基督徒都有的共同点。
If you're going to be a Christian on campus today, I hope that you stand for the enormous common ground.
所以我相信，我希望如果你是在一个校园的基督徒，我希望你的重心是放在这一个大家共同的信仰上。
Yeah, so do your job. Let me talk about. So, if you may say, well, I don't see any Christians at my workplace, almost no Christians.
你可能会这个样说，在我工作的地方，我根本就看不到其他的基督徒。
Actually, there are a lot of Christians.
但事实上，你知道，应该是有其他基督徒。
This is a really good book. The author's name is Skip. Skip Baccarello.
Baccarello.
I have a copy. You're welcome to come and flip through it afterwards. Skip was at our church this week to actually speak on the topic of finding God in Silicon Valley.
Yeah, this book's作者 Skin 他上个礼拜来我们的教会给了一些演讲，所以他写的这个书。
Yeah, you're welcome to come look at it. It just has stories, life stories about many, many, many people who found God and who lives their faith out in Silicon Valley.
在这本书，他大部分都是讲故事，他就是说一个接着一个在硅谷这里做事的人，他怎么样来认识神的故事。
Yeah, so I encourage you to look at it.Different ways in which they live their lives out as Christians at work.
也就是说，这些人怎么样在他的工作场合把他的信仰活出来
？Okay, so one is performing your job, the other is sharing your life. Sharing your life and spend more time on.
所以一方面就是说你要把工作做好，另外一方面就是你怎么样来分享你的生命。
Yeah, so you know, I often wonder why there are so few visible Christian faculty.Maybe you might wonder about it in your workplace, but on campus, it's like there seem to be no Christians.
可能如果你觉得你在工作场合基督徒非常少的话，我告诉你，在大学校园里面，这个基督徒的老师好像看起来很少。
Yeah, why? It seems like there's an identity crisis. How could there be so few Christians?
好像大家都不知道自己的身份是什么，就是为什么会
missing in action.
Yeah, 好像这一些就是被设计下来的一些人，因为的信仰什么今日。
One reason is I think just fear.
我觉得其中有一个原因是恐惧。
You know, just like this guy, this green guy. It's when you stand out, you know, you get self-conscious. It's like, I don't know, like a, you know, an animal, like a fish. When he's in very light-colored sand, he turns light.When it's a very dark color sand, it becomes dark. It's a natural defensive protection instinct because it doesn't want to stand out.
Yeah, you see this 绿的人在那个蓝的里面把 像特别的明显，大部分人都不愿意这个样子，就好像一条鱼一样，如果它在一个沙很浅的颜色的沙，它会身体变成浅色，如果沙的颜色深，这个鱼就会变成深色，这是一个保护它自己的功用。
Yeah, and so if we are a Christian faculty member, we identify and say, I'm a Christian, and you're out of yoga, then oftentimes you could become a target.
So if I'm a Christian teacher, and my teacher is not a Christian teacher, I could become a target of someone else.
And then the other thing is time. We often say, once I become a Christian, then I have to deal with so many things, you know, that I don't have to worry about if I just hide.
另外一个原因呢，就是时间。我们大家都知道，我们做基督徒，我们说讲啊，基督徒好忙啊，是的。
Yeah, and of course another one is I'm afraid if I say I'm a Christian, then people are going to say, huh, if a Christian is going to do this, a Christian is going to take the last parking spot just before I get there. We're just afraid that somebody would just hold up ourselves to a high standard.
还有另外一个因素，就是一旦别人知道你是基督徒的话，人家的标准就会提高，所以你就担心你可能达不到那个标准。
So let me talk about the fear part first.
所以我先跟大家讲一下。
So let me introduce you to another book. This is a really great book, and I want to give it to every Christian professor I know. It's called A Grander Story of Anglican. Don't reveal yet. Yeah, thank you. So you can want the first one. So,
就借上这一本书，如果你是一个基督徒的老师，我真希望你能拥有这本书，这是一本。
It's just an invitation to Christian professors. Had a central metaphor is this. He says, he describes, he was traveling on a raft through the Grand Canyon.
他这个形象是怎么来的？他说这个作者说有一天他在大峡谷在那里游玩
Traveling through
the river.
Yeah, on a raft.He says, when you look up and you see those fantastic walls, and you see 85,000 square feet of water going by every second, you know you are part of a grander story.
当他看到那旁边有这么高的山，这么样深的峡谷，那个水这么极快的流过去，当他看到那一点的时候，他就发现自己是一个大图画中间一个小小。
My story, he said, is part of a bigger story.
也就是说，他的故事是一个更大的故事中间的一点。
Yeah, and to be a faculty, he says, is to be part of God's grander story. Today, especially on the American campus.
在美国的校园，尤其是在美国的校园，如果你是一个基督徒的老师，你只是这个大故事中间的一点。
Because everything is downstream from the American university.
你要知道，现在社会的风气都是从美国的校园流出来的。
不只是风气，人格、ideas, character, formations, these all flow from America. The whole world comes to American universities to go out.
一切的理想、一切的主义、一切的思想、一切的创新，全世界的人都来美国的校园去，这些东西都是从美国的校园。
I would say it's Silicon Valley. The whole world is coming to Silicon Valley as young people working in these places.
我说硅谷今天也是一样，全世界的年轻人都到这里来，在这里的科技公司工作。
And this book contains some very touching real life stories about Christian faculty who wrestle with different challenges.
这一本书也是很多其他基督徒教授的故事，当他们在为这一些事情在那里怎么讲挣扎的时候。
I want to read you a little excerpt from written by a man called Walter Bradley. He's a mechanical engineer professor.
这里给大家读一个故事，是一个 mechanical engineer, 工业 mechanical engineer, 机械工程教授的一个故事。
Yeah, so he's describing what happened when he's a new professor. He was at a Colorado School of Mines. He graduated from UT Austin. He's a Colorado.He says, in my first semester at Colorado, I decided I would use a poster in my office as a means of identifying myself as a follower of Jesus.
他那个时候大学毕业了，就博士毕业了以后，就到科拉多州的一个大学去教书。他一开始教书的时候，他就决定要在他的墙上放一个poster， 要让别人知道他是一个基督徒。
And he said, so my wife and I went to a bookstore and picked a big, eye-catching, colorful peace symbol. And it says, if you want real peace, follow Jesus. So he prayed about this with his wife. He went to his office and he put it on his bulletin board as soon as he arrived at work. He said, but I soon took it down because I was overcome with fear of what my colleagues might think if they come into my office. Anne was so disappointed when I told her that evening that the reason I had no comments on my poster is because I took it down. He did this, he says, then they went back, went up again Tuesday, he went down again, he went up again and went down again each day. Finally, he prayed and he decided he's just going to leave it on. First he asked himself, maybe I can pick something more subtle, like falling water, it says living water, and nobody will know. So eventually, he left it on there. The colleague came in, looked up. This guy was a Unitarian, looked up, and then looked back down and started to talk about business again. Yeah, he said, so I left that poster out there for all 8 years I stayed at that school. Then he talked about his second school. He's already a tenured professor. He planned that he would prepare a 45-minute lecture and save 5 minutes to talk about his personal biographic sketch and to say that the most important thing to know about me is that I'm a follower of Jesus Christ. Yeah. So, and that he hopes that they would see a major difference in his life. So he goes, now he's a tenured professor, he goes up there, he gives his 45-minute lecture perfectly, and then he chickened out. The next day, again, gives a perfect 45-minute lecture, another panic attack, and then no testimony. He did this for 22 classes in a row. Then he, one day, he just finally, just before he handed out his final exam, he took the time, 5 minutes to share his faith. He said, most students probably don't remember, but it was a very big moment for me in my life. So I would say, you know, it's like getting into the water. It always feels cold when you first jump in, and suddenly it doesn't feel cold
anymore.
And once you've done it, you can't take it back anyway. People want to look me up, they can go to YouTube, they can go to the web, they'll see my sermons as well as my lectures. The problem is, you know, we often self-censor. It's not somebody told you, don't talk about your faith. We just shut up automatically, like a defensive
mechanism.
So, Judith, you know, start by letting people know, share a little bit. Just don't hide. Don't hide. Somebody say, what did you do this weekend? Oh, I had a nice weekend. You can say, I had a great weekend. I went to a Christian retreat and heard this crazy guy talk. Okay?
So, I want to give everyone the advice that you 方说朋友问你这个周末做了什么的时候，你就真实的，比方说你来了营会，你就告诉别人。
Just don't self-censor.
要不要自己不让自己说。
Okay, so fear is one problem, but time is another problem.
所以惧怕是一个原因，是没有时间是第二
个。Here's a good book. This is written by Hummel. It's a 1994 classic. It's called The Tyranny of the Urgent.
怎么翻译呢？紧急事情的暴君吧 ，Tyranny of Urgent。
He was a former director of faculty ministries for university. And he basically reflected on the fact that actually there are many things in our lives that are urgent.
这本书告诉我们说是的，人生有很多很紧急的事情。
The urgent hijacks our lives, but the urgent is not always very important.
因为这些紧急的事情好像我们的生命就被它抢夺去了，但你要记得紧急的事情
So, you know, I have a lot of things I have to do in my life. I'm a professor, I speak at church, and then I actually co-founded a company. So, all these things are in my life.
我这一生非常忙，大家知道我是一个教授，而且我也是在教会里有很多的服事讲道。我也是一个公司的创立人。
Every so often, I'm a husband and a father too. So, what Hummel observed after all this is he says, he proposed you have a plan for daily time with God, weekly evaluation, and monthly planning. He says, that should be the regular rhythm of life. And in fact, you know, we don't have time to spend on, we don't have time to spend on how to not do, how to take a real rest. But I would say this is the foundation. If you want to know how to improve your work, your serving at work, then take your time with God.
所以如果我给你任何的建议，如果你在工作上面你能够好好的服侍神、服侍人的话，你就是每一天都需要花时间跟神在一起。
This morning we already talked about this, but in John 15, this is a very important verse 5. Jesus said, I am the vine, you are the branches. If you remain in me and I in you, you will bear much fruit. But apart from me, you can do nothing.
这是耶稣在约翰福音十五章说的：“我是葡萄树，你们是枝子。你们若在我的里面，我也在你们里面，你们就多结果子。因为除了我以外，你们什么都不能做。”
We spend a lot of time thinking how to do this, how to do that. How to is just trust God. Just trust God.
我们常常花很多时间在想我怎么样解决这个问题，怎样解决那个问题。事实上，最重要的解决就是你先到神。
You are not there by accident. He knows what you need. Just trust him.
你在那个情况之下不是一个偶然，所以你知道神，求神来帮助你，来信任他。
So let me talk practically. We say 很容易啊，你怎么做这件事？ Just love people, love God and love people. But practically speaking, how do we love God and love people?
我们说，只要爱人、爱神的话，我们就可以在工作的地方荣耀神。但我们怎么样实际的把它活出来呢
？So I'm going to talk a little bit about honor. The love to love someone is to ascribe high value, to honor them, to say they are valuable to me.
所以第一点，也就是说啊，你周围的人看你有价值。
So you know, take the time to get to know them.Take the time to see them as human beings.
花一点点时间来认识他们，把他们当作人待。
I will tell you, most of the time we treat people around us as functional and useful. If they are useful, it's because they are part of a job that I have to do. We don't actually see their value.
我们常常犯的这个错误，就把周围的人看到他们到底有什么样的作用，看到说对于这个工作上面。
But I tell you, if you honor those around you, not only are you doing what God wants you to do, you're doing something that actually is enhancing, career enhancing.
所以如果你真的把人然后当作有价值的人带的话，不仅就是说你可以为神做见证，甚至对你的工作上都有益。
So how do you? So I'm going to talk about something called DARE, D-A-R-E, dialogue, affirm, resolve conflicts, and evangelize. DARE to love.
第一个是对话，第二是肯定，第三个是解决冲突，第四个是忏悔。So
when Paul in the Acts in 17 went into Athens, you remember it says he was greatly distressed because Athens was a city full of idols.
记不记得使徒行传17章说保罗到了雅典的时候，他心中非常的焦急，因为看到那里到处都是偶像。Yeah,
you would think you go to a workplace, oh, nobody knows anything about God, you're all worried. And, but instead it says Paul reasoned with them.
可能你刚一个工作场合，你到处一看，说你的同事没有一个是基督徒，心里焦急。 心里着急，对。那但是保罗呢？圣经告诉我们说，保罗就在那里跟别人用道理来谈道理。Reason
that Greek word is right, telekoumai. It just means not preaching. He's conversing, having conversation.
并不是说他在那里说服别人，而是在那里跟别人有真正的对话交流。我们
做见证的时候，我们就会觉得自己应该在讲。But what does Paul do? That's not what Paul does. So here, he uses something like a Socratic method. Okay? Socratic method is named after Socrates. You don't begin by criticizing the other worldview. You try to go inside sympathetically to the other person's worldview. You try to listen, you try to think like them. Not laughing, not screaming, not yelling. You just listen. And because you want to go inside,
right?
You go inside and then you ask questions from the inside out. Ask questions of the worldview. From its own perspective and its standards. So if this is right, Paul says, oh, you worship everything. I see you also worship a God you don't even know. This is the unknown God. You're a religious person. And so who is this God? I'm here to tell you about that.
所以保罗也就是说，我看到你们有敬拜很多的偶像，甚至其中有一个是未知之神。所以就从那个角度开始，把他们带进他自己的心。So mostly it's
a conversation. Conversation means you want to listen, you want to learn something.
所以对话很重要的，第一个是要听，第二是要学。Yeah,
they say Christians need to create safe space so people can say exactly what's really on their mind instead of what they think you want to hear.
有些人对基督徒的建议就是，你需要制造这种安全的空间，在这个空间之内，别人可以真正的说他心中的想法。So,
dialogue, affirm. Affirm means to ascribe high value to someone.
第二点是肯定，肯定也就是把别人当作有很高价值。I
tell this to the young professors, like when I talk about how to teach, I said, you human beings have intrinsic value.
所以当我教导年轻的教授怎么样教书的时候，告诉他们说：“你要记得，人都是有内在价值的。”Intrinsic
value is not the same as functional, not the same as commercial value.
不在于这个人的商业价值是什么。It's
not the same as functional value.
不在于这个人的功能价值是什么。Functional
value is how useful they are to you. Intrinsic value means they are valuable even when they're not useful to you.
这个内在价值，就不管这个人对你有用没有用，他都是有价值的。
If you treat people like that, you will do just fine.
如果你真的以这种态度对待人的话，你一定是你的人际关系应该很好。But
just like 今天早上 what we heard, right? Human being of course knows that Christian knows that human beings have intrinsic value.
所以基督徒应该都知道，人都是有内在价值。
Because we, like he said, we are made in His image. redeemed by His blood, and we are His, we are crafted for His purpose.
我们是借着他的形象创的，我们是他宝血赎回的，而且我们也是为他的工作所创的。
And this is so important because people forget they are worth something.
这一点非常的重要，因为有些人自己都会忘记自己是有价值的。
We forget that we are worth something. Danny Mayer, he's a New York restaurateur, the CEO of this hospitality.
有一个人叫 Danny Mayer， 他是在纽约开了很多很多的餐馆，这样对。
Yeah, he says everyone is wearing an invisible sign. He says, how do you be a good restaurateur? How do you open a good restaurant? He says, remember, everyone is wearing an invisible sign on their chest.
他说你怎么样能够做一个开一个成功的餐馆呢？他就是说你开餐馆的人要记得每一个顾客都穿着一件衣服，上面有几个你看不见的字，就是说我需要，你觉得我很重要。
I want you to make me feel important. And so actually we are, human beings are like that. After Genesis 3, after we are separated from God, we need every moment of our lives to know we are important.
人都是这样，尤其在人堕落以后，每个人都是需要别人肯定，说自己是很有价值的。
And he said, your job is to read and figure out how to do that.
他告诉他的那些服侍的那些 waiter waitress， 就是说，你每个人都要记得这一点。So
let me just so human beings need something called bonding.
人都是需要有这个 bonding。 Dear, that is water in the back. If you're really sleepy right now, go there, get a bottle of water, and when you come back out, you know, it's fucking. I know it's a lot of stuff. So it's not a prayer, but it's okay to get some water.
I work with her because really I just do what she tells me to do. I stop my class when she wants to have a drink.
Do you want a bottle of water?
No, I don't need it.
人都是需要人跟人中间啊，是需要建立关系的。
Okay. So bonding takes a lot of work and time. It involves in physical, emotional, intellectual, spiritual.
建立这种关系事实上是需要花很多的功夫的，因为建立关系包括身体，包括情绪，包括 包括你的意志，也包括你的属灵方面。
Let me just say a couple more things about bonding. We really need bonding. We need bonding actually in every setting that we have, a church, at work, in a family.
在家庭里，在工作里，在教会里，我们人都需要建立关系。They
say that you know babies who don't get touched, you know, they don't get much touch. They are much more likely to get sick. They're much more likely to run into health problems.
甚至婴儿如果没有常常被别人抱的时候，都还比较容易生病。Okay,
and they say actually you know, women bond more easily than men.
女人中间比较容易建立关系。Men
have a hard time sharing what's on their minds.
男人跟男人之间比较困难，因为比较不容易把心里的事情说出来。But
you know, bonding leads to healthier lives. People live longer. People who bond easily live longer.
但如果人能建立关系的话，这个人就可以活得更健康，然后活得更久。So
actually, people who have one daughter, a daughter lives longer than people who don't. People who are married live longer than people who don't. Things like this is just a lot of bonding. People who have a pet live longer than people who don't.
有女儿的人好像活得比较长，有太太的人可能活得比较长，有猫有狗的人甚至可以活得比较长。
It's just that people need bonding.
因为人都需要关系。So
let me talk about conflict resolution. What is a conflict?
所以在这里跟大家讲，如果你的关系出了毛病，就是有了冲突，该怎么办？
So a conflict, and here's a good definition that I find useful. A conflict is a difference, so two groups have a difference. Maybe it's a difference about something, some opinion.
冲突的定义，第一点就是说两个人或两群人中间意见不同。意见不同
is the worst difference. The second is it's characterized by tension, emotionality, some sort of polarization of emotions.
结果情绪就包括在内，因为意见不同，人的情绪就紧张，然后大家就变得更极端。Yeah,
and then where the bonding is broken.
最糟糕的就是这个关系因此破裂。So
where I got this definition from was from a psychologist, and he basically said the most important thing of the three is the last one, the bonding is broken.
所以这个教导我们的那个心理老师跟我们说，最重要的呢就是冲突会造成人际关系的破裂。He
says if you have a difference, it's okay. If you have tension, even emotionality, it's okay. But don't break the bond.
所以第一点跟第二点的发生呢，事实上都还可以，但是第三点最重要的就是不要把关系。
So the key to conflict resolution is to keep the bond.
也就是要解决冲突最重要的一个基本原则，就是关系不能裂。You
know, so the book of Ephesians put it this way. It says, make every effort to keep the unity of the Spirit through the bond of peace.
以弗所书这样说，要竭力保守，圣灵所赐合而为一的心。
We often pray, Lord, give us unity. But God says, you already have unity. Right? In me, you already have unity, but you have to keep the bond. So here, you know, in church, sometimes we run into a conflict for good reason, bad reason. You and somebody has a difference.
比方说，在教会里面，你跟另外一个人中间意见不合。意见不合，很多原因啊。
And then you don't want to talk to them.
可能因此你就不想跟这个人再说话。And
so when they come this way, you go the other way.
这个人从这里来，你从那里走。You
just avoid them.
就是要避免这个人。It
is, but that's not solving the conflict.
但你这个并不是解决你们的冲突。Yeah,
so let me talk about conflict resolution. And the key is to keep the bond.
解决冲突最重要的基础就是你要保持关系。Remember
this morning, Pastor Liu said, love requires faith.
Okay. 今天早上陆传道告诉我们说，爱是需要信心。You
have to believe that that person is someone you can reach.
你要相信这一个人是你能够跟他解决问题的人。So
if two people have conflict, you need to remember and believe that that person is a human being that you want to and you can reach.
如果你跟另外一个人有冲突的时候，非常要重要记得，这一个人他是一个人，而你是愿意跟他保持这种关系的人。So
the guy who taught us this, he was a hostage negotiator.
教我们这一些呢，他自己是一个人质的一个学员，呀。So
when the police has a difficult tension position, they send him in to talk to the guy with the gun.
所以如果有人质的问题发生的时候，警察就会找他，让他去做和解的工作。He
says when somebody is pointing a gun at your head, you work really hard to keep the bond.
他就说，如果有一个凶犯把枪对着你的时候，你最重要的一点就是。
Because it's much harder to kill a person to kill than to kill a thing. So you just keep talking to them. You just say, oh yeah, where are you from? Blah 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 blah. Because you have to keep the bond. So let me give you an example. Ashley Smith. You may not remember her, but a number of years ago, she was in the news a lot. Because she lived in Memphis, and one day, a criminal broke through a court. He stole a gun, he shot one of the guards, and shot one of the judges, and escaped.
这件事情发生在Memphis，有一个囚犯，他抢了那个警察的枪，然后把警察跟那个法官都杀死，然后一个人跑出去了。
And he was just barging around, he ran into an apartment, and it was Ashley Smith's apartment.
结果他就跑进一个人的公寓，那个人的公寓刚好那个女的叫Ashley Smith。
So he was holding a gun to her.
然后他就把那个枪对着人。
And Ashley Smith just started talking to him.
然后Ashley Smith就开始跟他对话。
She says, don't kill me. You know, my husband died, and I have one daughter. If you kill me, then she will have no daddy and no mommy.
他就跟这个人讲说，请你千万不要杀我，因为我丈夫死了，我只有一个女儿。如果你杀了我的话，我女儿就父母双亡。Ashley
Smith had just become a Christian.
那个时候，Ashley Smith 刚刚成为一个基督徒。And
she was reading a book called The Purpose Driven Life.
那时候正在看一本书，叫《标杆女神》。
She starts talking. She says, "You know, I've just been reading this book. I don't think it's an accident that you came into my apartment."
告诉这个人说，我正在看这本书，我觉得你闯进我的公寓并不是偶然。And
then she talked to him. She said, you know, my husband, he was a gang member, and he died because someone killed him. He died in my arms. You know, he was stabbed to death.
然后他就一直不停地跟他讲，讲他的丈夫是怎么样死的，在他的手里面死的，在他的怀抱里死的。And then
she cooked for him, baked pancakes, she read Bible to him, and then 9 hours later, he surrendered. There was no violence.
结果这个女的就继续地为这个人煮东西、做东西吃，然后读圣经给他听。结果这个人9个小时以后就投降。So
afterwards, the police said, what Ashley did is exactly what you should do, because you keep the bond.
没有多久，以后警察就说，Ashley所做的正事，他最需要做的就是他跟这个人中间那个关系没有破裂。You
see, when we are in a conflict situation, we sometimes do not see the human being.
因为当我们跟一个人有冲突的时候，我们常常就忘记了，在这个冲突背后是一个人。
Yeah, we just see, oh, you are evil, you're horrible. You know, you are. I can't understand how you could be like this. All we see is that.
我们有时候所看到，就是这个人简直太莫名其妙了，这个人怎么会这个样子？简直是一个太恶劣了。Yeah,
so last example.
最后一个例子。
Reagan and Gorbachev.
是关于 Reagan 跟 Gorbachev.
When Reagan and Gorbachev were negotiating a nuclear treaty.
当他们两个那个时候在商议怎么样去和的时候。
Right. And so one day, Reagan was very upset, just got up and walked away. And according to the memoirs of his helper, he suddenly stopped at the door and then he turned around. He said to Gorbachev, he said, Mikhail, may I call you Mikhail?
然后他就对着Gorbachev说，Mikhail，因为Mikhail是他的first name，就是我可不可以叫你这个名字？
He said, this is much too important.
这件事太重要了。Can
we just talk one-on-one with just translators?
就我们两个就一对一把带着我们的翻译谈就行了。Later,
they say that was a turning point, because they had a conversation.
后来人家就是说根据记录呢，这是整个这个他们之间的关系的转折点。
Gorbachev, when he was asked what happened, he said, we stopped demonizing each other. We stopped demonizing each other. It means that I look at you not with the eyes that I used to look at. I look at you just like in second reading. I no longer see them as I used to. I see through the eyes that Christ sees.
也就是跟你刚才所说的，不再以前的眼光来看我，我是以基督的眼光来看你。So
you know, I remember once I was in an argument with my daughter. I love my daughter, but we were in an argument.
我记得有一次我跟我的女儿吵架，我非常爱我的女儿。But
we were just, she was crazy, and she thought I was crazy.
她觉得我疯了，我觉得她疯了。And
suddenly I felt this, and I said to her, no matter what we say to each other today, you are my daughter and I love you.
就到最后，我跟我女儿说，不管我们今天说了什么，我要你知道，你
So if you tie, if you keep the bond, you will be able to resolve the conflict.
所以如果你能保持住关系的话，你一定可以解决你们中间的冲突。
So I would say at work, right? At work, there probably are more difficult difficult relationships than other relationships. Some relationships could be very difficult.
我觉得在工作的时候，有时候有一些困难的关系，可能是更加的困难。
Just deal with those early. Pray hard and go and keep the bond. Don't demonize the other person.
所以如果你有问题发生的时候，不要等很久，赶快的把问题拿出来，而且要记得，你要把对方当人，你要保持住你们的关系。
Yeah. So, you know, that's called the fresh fish principle.
所以这个原则叫新鲜的鱼。
You know, a fish that's under the table, it stinks.
一个鱼，如果你把它放在桌子底下，那个鱼会发臭。
You don't talk about it, it still stinks.
但如果你更是假装它不存在的话，那个鱼就越臭。
But if you take it out and you clean it,
但如果你把鱼拿出来，把它清理一下，
you just cook it.
然后你把它煮了，
you eat it.
两个人都吃了，
you're gonna be good.
大家都好。
When I was working at a company, I wanted to tell these people about this principle. So I took this to work. This is a fish. My brother gave me this because he got this one after, but it's so lively, I can't believe it, right? This looks so real. So I took this to work and I told my team, I said, I like fresh fish.
So
there's a fresh principle. If you have an issue with anything, you want to put the fish on the table, you just come into my office, it's near the door, just shake the fish. Yeah. So it's the same thing, you know, in our relationship, just go shake the fish, you know, just talk to them.
所以在我们的人际关系中间，你也保持新鲜鱼的原则，早一点把它拿出来。是凭信心做的事
，by faith. Okay, and also a couple other practical things about peacemaking and healing, relationship reconciliation. This ministry reconciliation. Listen well, ask good questions.
还有另外一个很重要的原则，就是好好的去听，然后问问题。
Yeah. Like, ask a question means, you say, let me repeat what I heard. Is this what you said? Just say it again, so that they know that you heard them.
有一个很好的方法就是说，我听到你是这个样说的，然后你重新讲一遍，然后问人家说，我听得对不对？
Yeah, right. So, when we did this couples workshop for couples one year in Ithaca.
有一年我们有做这个 workshop.
Not this workshop, but we were doing couples. At the end, we told them, here's a candle. Each of you go to a different part of our house, right? And take this candle with you, light a candle. And then you say, you talk for 5 minutes, uninterrupted, and I listen. You can only ask clarifying questions, listen. And then I talk for 5 minutes, and you just listen. You cannot interrupt, just no argue, just listen and clarifying questions. And then the two of you talk for 5 minutes, and in 15 minutes, come back.
我们给大家一个功课，就是每个人拿一个蜡烛，一对夫妻啊，拿一个蜡烛，就是说先在第5分钟让其中一个人先说，这个说话的时候，对方你是不可以打扰他，你只能问一些澄清的问题。 然后接下5分钟，另外一个人可以加5分钟，这个对方也不可以打扰。然后最后的5分钟，你们俩可以有对话，总共15分钟。
The things you most want the other person to hear.
你那个5分钟要讲的是你最希望对方能够听到的话。You
know what happened? After 15 minutes, nobody came back. They just kept talking.
发现15分钟以后没有一对夫妻回来，大家都在继续的讲。
So just dialogue. We need to be heard.
要说要对话，因为每个人都希望对方。It's
conflict resolution.
所以这个是解决冲突。
我们到什么时候？
在8分。
OK， 那最后就是 evangelism。
所以最后这一点怎么样传福音？我们说
evangelism 主要是什么？是 the main way is to is how you live, not what you say, right? But you should also think about what you say.
虽然传福音，我们说在工作场合最重要的是身传，但是怎么样口传也蛮重要的。So
if you're a Christian professor, this book in the appendix, it is a talk about how to legally and appropriately share. In other words, legally, what can you do as a professor? Can I put a poster up? Can I, you know, what can I say and not say?
所以在这本书在最后的那个附加的地方，他会告诉你说，如果你身为一个美国的教授，有哪些事情是合法可以做？比方说，可不可以在墙上贴一个 poster 呢？有哪些事情是合法？
Can you share? Can you invite Christian? You know all these things. So it's useful to know it if you are going to be a professor. I hope lots of people want to be professors.
所以如果你想要做教授的话，这个是很值得知道。
Yeah, I think it's the most wonderful job in the world. And also, if you are going to, I'd say this to professors, but if you are going to be, think about a way to prepare a 15-minute pre-evangelistic talk.
另外一个就是准备15分钟一个，就是说，传福音之前的一个。Just
a short talks with an easy ramp-up that can be given to general people. But lead you back to the cross or something.
也就是说，你的题目是一个很普遍、大家有兴趣的题目，而你可以借着这个题目带你往信仰、谈信仰的方向走。So
people ask me to give a talk about leadership. So I said three things I learned through my career, and I list those three things, and then I link them to my faith.
比方说，有人要求我讲怎么样做领导，我就准备说三件事情我学习，然后哒哒哒，然后接着带领他们进入。Somebody
wants to talk about happiness. Maybe talk about what happiness is. Why it's the hard part is not about happiness. Why is it so hard to find it?
比方说，有人问我讲什么是幸福快乐，我就会说什么是幸福快乐，但最难的可能就是说为什么这么不容易得到。Success,
sin, just link everything to Christ.
也就是说，在你讲这些题目，你都归结到基督的身上。So
you have a conversation, you have everything, but somehow everything goes back there.
你跟别人可以有这个对话，但是最后能够带回到你。Yeah,
I think all professors, I think all Christians, will benefit to thinking through and writing down your story or your type of pre-evangelistic talk about big questions in life.
所以我觉得每一个人，如果你能写出一个15分钟的一个，就是顾到前面的这个大题目的话，我相信都是有帮助。Okay, so
you know, there's this book that I like just because of the amazing writing. It's just beautiful writing by Gene Weingarten. He's a Washington Post editor and award-winning writer. It's called The Fiddler in the Subway. I recommend it just for fun, just to read for fun, because of the beautiful writing.
我跟大家介绍一本书，这本书写的非常的好，这个作者自己得过很多的奖。But
in particular, this book is a lot of his own writing, short stories. But in particular, in the introduction, he teaches people how to write.
这本书就是他自己写的一些短篇文章，但最重要一开始的时候，他说他怎么样教别人怎么样写。He
says, "I was the editor at the Washington Post." When a new reporter comes in, he writes a short story, and I would take him into my room and give him the talk.
他说我是华盛顿邮报的编辑，所以当有一个新的记者来的时候，写一篇文章，我就让他们进到我的房间，然后跟他们有这样的一个对话。
I would say, "What's your article about?"
我就问他说，你这篇写的是什么？
He says, "Oh, it's about a soccer mom who had a hard time, a single mom who had a hard time making ends meet, but still had to bring her kids to soccer." And he says, "No, that's not what your story is about."
记者会说，我这个是讲的一个足球妈妈，她非常的困难，但她还是继续要帮助别人，所以要把小孩带去足球。
He said, "Your story is about the meaning of life."
就我跟他讲，不，这不是那个主题，你主题应该是生命的意义。Whatever
you write about, it is about the meaning of life.
不管你写的是什么，你这篇一定就是要关于生命。Until
you understand that, you will not write for me in this newspaper.
除非你能了解这一点，你不可能在这一个报纸为我写作。
You get the application.
你知道这个怎么应用在我们身上
？You see, you're a Christian.
我们是基督徒。
People ask, how can I Christianize my talk? How can I Christianize the way I work?
有些人说我怎么样能够让我的工作基督化
？Actually, everything is about your life because your life is so filled with the life of God. But that's everything, I say. It's all about the meaning of life.
是的，你跟你所做的一切的事情都是跟你这个基督的生命有关系，因为一切的事情都是关于生命的意义。
See, to Weingarten, who is an atheist, he says, you know, the meaning of life is Kafka. Kafka. Kafka says, meaning of life is we die. The way we live, the way we lust, the way we fight is because we die.
But it,这个作者他不是一个基督徒，对他而言，生命的意义就是死。
Yeah, he says the meaning of life is we die, and yet Christians, you know, Jesus Christ says the meaning of life is that I die for you.
但对于基督徒而言，其生命的意义就是耶稣基督为我们死。
Right, so all his writings, 写，然后说啊，人生是一声叹息。That's kind of 结论。但是我们说谢谢啊，人生多棒。That's the difference. It's the punchline is different because what we see is different.
那么对我们而言，那个最终结的那个怎么讲？就是说，那个终结的就是 it's the meaning.
So, you know, if I ask you what is unique about Christianity?
如果我对你讲说基督教有什么特别的特征
？I would say four things.Automatically come to mind for me. It's love, sin, salvation, and grace.
So, 对我而言是这四点。
So, and you can start from any one of those, and you'll end up with the middle, which is Christ crucified.
你可以从任何一个点来谈，到最后都会谈到中间，也就是耶稣基督为我们钉十字架。
In fact, everything you talk about, almost anything, make me think of the incredible thing that God did.
我无论谈任何一个题目，都会让我想到神为我们做的这一件。
There is this writing by Hermann Rock, an Austrian writer. In fact, it's on a plaque hanging over our bedroom wall.
我们非常喜欢这句话，我们把它挂在我们的卧房的墙上。
Hermann Rock is not a Christian.
虽然这个人不是一个基督徒。
But he said something. He said, "Those who live by the sea can hardly form a single thought of which the sea."
如果你是住在海的旁边，你不可能有任何一个思想不会想到海不会在其中。
If you live by the sea, he says, you are so shaped by the sea that you can hardly think of anything of which there is no sea.
如果你是活在海边，你的生命是这个样子，跟海息息相关，你不可能有一个思想不会有海的影响。
Jesus says, remain in me and I will remain in you and you will bear much fruit. And apart from me, you can do nothing.
所以耶稣这样跟我们说，住在我的里面，我也住在你们里，你们的里面。因为除了我以外，你们什么都不能做。
住在耶稣里就好像是活在海边一样，你做任何东西都会想到海。You cannot help but think of it.Let me just summarize, because we're finishing with the time. So, to summarize, right? We talked about understanding your calling, that your job has eternal significance, that you are Christ's ambassador. That's on the first half of today. The second half, we talk about strengthening your relationships, relationship 101, to dialogue, to affirm, to resolve conflict, and to evangelize. And so, let me just end.By saying that you do have a calling. God intends to bless you and to bless others through your work. And this, I like to use this graph again because here is a man. When I saw him, I said, this is a very blessed man because he is in the rain. He's holding an umbrella, but he's not holding it over himself. He's only holding it over his cello. And I said, anyone who can find something more important than himself to work on is a very blessed man.Pray that you'll be able to bring your passion to work, to live like this guy lives. Find the reason, the purpose that God put you to where you are at work. 们这个祷告我们结束。Dear Lord, we thank you for this afternoon that we could spend together. We know that there are many challenges that face us when we go to our workplace. But we thank you, Lord, that you have overcome the world, that you have sent us, that you have prayed for us.That you have protected us and that you will sanctify us. And that you want us to learn and grow dealing with relationships with you right now. We pray that we may honor you, we may glorify you. Lord, we are your people, sheep of your shepherd, of your pastors. So as we go out into our workplace, Lord, we just invite you to lead us, to guide us, thatYou would make yourself at home in our workplace so that we may celebrate and we live as joyful exiles in this place, bringing your joy and your love to other people. Thank you, Lord, and we pray in Jesus' name. Amen.